Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're gonna be answering a viewer question. We're gonna be going over how we create a video card so that we can show one piece of footage at the same time as another piece of footage. This used to be called, in old school terms, a picture-in-picture effect, and we're gonna be going over a much more stylized and fun version of that. And the best part is that it's really easy to pull off, and you can do it all inside of Premiere Pro. So let's jump into it. So we're gonna start here by just adding the video clip of me standing here talking. This is actually where the work on the effect starts because you need to prepare it in your mind properly. This shot has me placed right in the center, but what I'm gonna do is zoom in and then move it in such a way so that I'm off to the left-hand side. To do this, use scale and positioning in the effects controls tab here. It's also worth noting that this clip was shot in 4K, so because I'm exporting in 1080p, I can zoom in without worrying about it looking bad. The reason we want to move it off center a bit is so that there's room to make it feel like the later insert of the video was thought through in advance. It would feel a little awkward if it was just placed over top of me. If that was what we were doing, then why wouldn't we just fully cut to it, you know? So we can start with it off to the side like this, or we could start with it more centered and then keyframe it to move in preparation for the other clip coming in. I'm going to be doing that second one. Now we're going to bring in the shot that we want to make the footage card out of. Place it on top of your base footage, and you're actually going to place it two layers above it. We'll get to the reason why in just a minute. But now that it's above your base layer, you should only see the top layer. But now we're actually going to drop it down in size. Go to your effects control tab and let's adjust the size amount here. Personally, for these sorts of shots, I like to bring it down to something below 50% size. It's actually going to be somewhere closer to 35 or 40%. If we drop it down to only 50%, assuming you're working with footage that's all of the same resolution, it'll take up exactly one quarter of your screen. But I want it to be even smaller than that because I don't want it going all the way over to the edge. I want to have some buffer room on all sides. Now that we've dropped the size, let's change the position with our position sliders. I like it to be situated somewhere around here, but based on your own personal video needs, it's totally a choice that's up to you. And from here, you can edit your clip as normal to make sure that the proper part of the clip is actually showing at the correct time. But even though we've technically achieved the effect at this point, we're going to be doing one more quick thing that will really help it to stand out as professional. Depending on the coloring of your clip, it might be hard to have a clear distinction between your normal clip and the smaller one. And in our case, there's a lot of gray in both of them. So we're going to add a colored border around the entire smaller video layer. To do that, we're actually going to create a solid rectangle and place it behind or underneath our footage. And this is the reason why we brought it up an extra layer before. You can create an entire new solid and crop it if you like, but what I'm actually going to do is hit Ctrl or Command T, and then a text layer will pop up. Make sure it's actually situated underneath your footage layer in your timeline, between your top layer and your bottom one, and position it so that it lasts exactly as long as your top layer. But we're actually going to go up here to the Essential Graphics panel and delete the text. So now we just have an empty graphics box. And instead, we're going to go here to the page icon and add a new rectangle. It should pop up right on screen, and now we can grab it and stretch it out over our video. But you'll notice that you can only see where it's behind your footage when it's peeking out around the edges, so it acts like a small border. Size it however you want it to look. It's totally a personal stylistic choice, but I personally like a bit of a small, minimal border. From here, under Essential Graphics, you can change the color of the box if you'd like, and I'm going to change mine to be a nice Motion Array blue. Cool! Now our picture-in-picture effect looks really great, but we can take it another step further. If you try to animate your footage, or even fade it in and fade it out, you'll notice that you have to do exactly the same thing with your border in order to make it look right. So instead of doing all that work twice, let's nest our clips so that the border and the footage act as a single unit. Highlight both your clips, right-click, and then go to Nest, and name it whatever you like. Now, if we do something like, say, animate it to grow and pop into frame, the border and the footage will both work together. I'm just going to bring the size down to 0 and keyframe it. Then I'm going to move forward and bring it back up to the size of about 102. You'll notice that after nesting, your size percentage will be a little bit different. 100% will be the size of everything that you did before you nested. So we want it to be just a little bigger than it was originally. Then I'm going to go a couple frames forward and keyframe it down to be about 97%. Keep going forward a few frames at a time and keyframing it closer and closer to 100%. And now finally, I'm going to highlight all of the keyframes, right-click, and select Bezier. And this is what our effect looks like. This is a really simple way to add a stylish picture-in-picture effect that really works organically with your video. And guys, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, feel free to give it a like or share it with a fellow video editor friend. And if you want to keep up to date with all the great stuff that we have coming down the pipe, subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon to make sure that you see the next time that we post. But guys, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.